You know, you cannot predict the next hurdle that will come your way. But you can always have a mindset that is agile. If you are open to change, whenever a crisis hits you, which is unknown, you can at least anticipate it, understand it, and work along with others to find a solution on the spot. Life is not as complicated as we make it out to be.
Success to an outsider looks like it's all glitz and glamour. In reality, a lot goes behind it. It's the outcome of relentless innovation, adaptability to the unforeseen, years of persistence and hard work. Let's take a closer look into what truly lies beneath the surface. Not long ago, a common Indian household occurrence was one person on the roof trying to angle a huge antenna this way and that in an attempt to get the best possible signal for just a single TV channel. Less than three decades later, the average TV viewing experience has come a long way. Now, we have hundreds of HD quality TV channels being thrown directly into lakhs and lakhs of homes by invisible floating satellites in the sky. At the forefront of this television revolution in India is a company called Tata Sky, led by the genius of its CEO, Harith Nagpal. This sentiment has indeed rung true for most Indians, as Tata Sky already has the largest subscriber base among DTH companies, and it's still the fastest growing broadcasting service. Let's hear it from Harith himself about what's gone behind the scenes into Tata Sky's phenomenal success.
I don't think it's about what you sell, it's who you sell to and who are you producing for. If you understand the customer and the customer's needs and produce products for the customer, you could be in any industry. In the end, almost any product category is a commodity. Every other competitor of yours has the same technology, has the same insight. So you've got to look for a differentiator, and the differentiator also needs to be sustainable. In our case, we looked at service as a differentiator. The product won't fail, and if it fails, it will take minimal time for us to get it right so that you don't miss television. And it's taken a very long time for that reputation and for that belief to build. Whether you, me, or anybody in a town or village, the need for entertainment, information, education is universal. So you had to create a product which could travel into the insides of the villages and make it available at a price which was affordable for the person. Till the time you have a million, 2 million customers and you're handling about 5, 10, 20,000 calls a day, that's okay. I mean, you can handle through a call center. But when you have 18, 19, 20 million customers and you have 4 lakh calls coming in a day, you know, you'll reach a stage where half the city is taking calls and half the city is making calls. So you can't have a customer calling you for everything. That required innovation. So for things that you would earlier call the call center for, now you can do it in the comfort of your home through self-help. For example, you could recharge, you could manage your change your pack, you could explore what other services you can use, you can get help if your things are not working, and many other things. You know, a customer needs to only pay for what he likes to watch, and he has the power to select and change it as many times a year or whenever he wants to. For example, you know, I've got my pack open here in front of me, my two TVs in the house, and I can actually pull out, see this. This is what is configured on my gym room. This is what is configured in my TV room. I can on the fly change what channels I've subscribed to in each one of these and pay only for what I'm watching. So when a broadcaster is entrusting his content to me for distribution amongst customers, so our job is to encrypt the content and make it openable only by somebody who's legitimately subscribed to it. So that's where the securitization comes. A technology in search for a customer need will not succeed. Keep looking for customer insights and then asking technology to create products that fulfill those needs. You know, unlike today, while we were growing up, we did not have phones. We did not have access to cars and flights and, you know, internet and Google or you name it. If we had to read a book, we had to go to a library. If we had to travel, we had to use public transport. And resources were a constraint. It wasn't a rich world like it is today. It taught us one thing, to observe people and observing behavior, and then creating products and services to suit those needs. I think that's been the biggest teacher. COVID impacted us like it impacted anybody else. All of us realized that if we hadn't acted in time and acted the way we did, the business that we were running was at stake. We've been working on Microsoft Teams for the last 3 months. People picked up their straws from wherever they were and huddled into groups over video, got into meetings, and got into the grind. People who are willing to experiment, people who are willing to try out new things. I think that's what succeeds most in an unknown territory terrain like ours.